This video introduces how to execute a pick-and-place process for randomly stacked bolts, as shown. Up to now, we have finished vision system hardware setup, deep learning model training, robot communication configuration, and hand-eye calibration. The configuration of the vision project has also been completed in Mech-Vision. In this video, with the vision result, we can build a path planning project in Mech-Viz, and then configure the pick-and-place program for the robot to achieve picking. To avoid collision, the operational steps of picking and placing are set as follows. Move the robot to the initial pose. Move the robot to image capturing pose and get planned path from Mech-Viz. Perform picking according to planned path. Perform placing. In the second step, the robot needs to get planned path from Mech-Viz by standard interface communication. The project of Mech-Viz can provide the robot with path planning, collision detection, and simulation. Thus, let's begin with building a pick-and-place project in Mech-Viz to preview the picking path of the robot. Building a Mech-Viz project requires the following steps. Tool and scene objects configuration. Workflow creation. Collision detection configuration. Simulation. The Mech-Viz project we use is loading randomly stacked target objects from our application templates. First, configure the tool. Add the tool model in OBJ format, which has been modified in the model editor, to the model library. Double-click Default Tool. Enter the information in Tool Configuration and set the TCP. The TCP should be adjusted to match the actual tool center point. Please make sure that the TCP set in Mech-Viz is the same as that of the actual tool. After configuration, activate the tool. Save the project, and proceed to click the Configuration button to enter Target Object Editor. In Set Pick Point, check the relative position between the tool and the pick point. If the relative position is incorrect, please adjust the TCP of the tool in Mech-Viz and the TCP of the actual robot's tool until the relative position is correct. Next, add the scene object's models, including the models of bin, the robot's base, the robot's safety fence, and so on. Make a bin model. In practice, the bin is not fixed in one position. Each time the camera captures an image, Mech-Vision will send the bin's name and pose to Mech-Viz, so that Mech-Viz can update the bin's model, and then plan flexible path for the robot to enter and exit the bin. Here, we set the name as box. Set the scene model type as bin, and the object dimensions to be consistent with the actual bin. Now we will proceed with building the workflow for future path planning. There are 7 steps in total. First, move the robot to image capturing pose, which refers to the position where the camera captures images. At this position, the robot arm should not block the camera's field of view. Afterwards, record the robot's pose in the workflow. Second, trigger Mech-Vision project. Capture image and calculate the pick point of the workpiece. Third, check the result of the vision project. Fourth, smart path in bin. Automatically generate 2 waypoints, the enter bin point and the approach point. Fifth, calculate the actual pick point. Sixth, smart path in bin. Generate another 2 waypoints, the retreat point and the exit bin point. Lastly, move the robot to the intermediate pose. Record the robot's actual position in the workflow. Please note that the first step and the last step are only for simulation. No waypoints will be sent. Now, the workflow has been built. Let's move on to the configuration of collision detection. Given the case of randomly stacked bolts, collisions between the point cloud and the tool and the workpiece in bin, and the picked workpiece and the bin are likely to occur. What's more, the number and position of the workpieces in bin cannot be determined. To detect collisions, we need to obtain the workpiece's point cloud from the vision project. Therefore, enable point cloud collision detection. Choose point cloud cube as the point cloud form for collision detection, and set the collision detection threshold as needed. In this video, We are using smart path in bin, so the detection of collisions on target objects should also be enabled. This allows us to detect the collisions between the tool and the target object, and that between the held target object and seen objects. Next, click the Simulate button to simulate the workflow of the virtual robot. The simulation should be performed 10 times. After each simulation, move the workpiece to a different position. If all simulations proceed smoothly, the vision project can be used for the robot to perform picking. Now we have completed the configuration of Mech-Viz projects. Next, we need to configure the program for the robot. In this video, we use FANUC LR Mate 200 ID as an example. The example program we use is from our software. Please operate your robot according to actual use. Here are all the steps of the robot's pick and place program. First, set the tool frame. Make sure that the TCP of the robot's tool frame is the same as that in Mech-Viz, which has been set before in tool configuration. Modify the tool frame number in the robot program according to actual use. Next, teach initial pose. Move the robot to the initial position, which should be away from the objects to be picked and the surrounding devices, and should not block the camera's field of view. Teach the initial position in this step. Then, change the IP address of the robot to the IP address of the IPC. Afterwards, teach image capturing pose. Move the robot to image capturing pose, and record the current position. Next, the robot will get planned path from Mech-Viz, and save the acquired waypoints of the planned path to local variables. There are 5 waypoints in total: the enter bin point, the approach point, the pick point, the retreat point, and the exit bin point. Originally, the program only has 3 waypoints: the approach point, the pick point, and the retreat point. In this video, smart path in bin has been applied. Therefore, we need to add 2 waypoints in the program for the robot to save, which are the enter bin point and the exit bin point. Next, move the robot through the enter bin point and the approach point to the pick point. After approaching the pick point, set DO to close the gripper to pick the workpiece. Please modify the general output signal ID according to the actual situation. Next, move the robot to the retreat point and the exit bin point. Then, move the robot to the intermediate position and the placement position. Record the poses respectively. After approaching the place point, set DO to open the gripper to perform placing. In real application scenarios, please modify the general output signal ID and state according to the actual situation. So far, we have completed the configuration of the pick and place program for the robot. Now we can run the program to test the pick and place performance of the robot. We can add loop statement in the program when multiple pick and place tasks are required. These are all the steps for the robot to pick and place randomly stacked bolts. You can refer to our example programs and documentation for more information on complicated pick and place scenarios and the operation of other robots and PLCs.